Once you arrive at Reach Planner, you will see a page that looks like this. This is the saved plan menu, and any plan that you save will be available here for you to refer to later on or to reload, review, and copy. To start a new forecast, simply click this blue button and you're set. Say you want to plan an awareness campaign where reach is your key goal. You can choose to plan for just YouTube, or in this case, plan for YouTube alongside TV. This is where you'll start selecting individual settings that might be important for your campaign. Be sure to choose settings that align across both your YouTube and your television campaigns. You'll have the opportunity to add YouTube-specific information at a later step. Let's get started. First, select the country or region that you want to plan for. We're going to use Vietnam. You can also choose countries like France, Japan, and the US. In some countries like Japan, you get the ability to plan for individual regions as well as Kanto, Kansai, and Chukyo. Next, you'll select an age and gender that aligns with both your TV and YouTube plan. TV is planned against an audience based on age and gender. So in order to create a like-for-like forecast, we're going to use a similar target demographic across your TV and YouTube campaign. Today, we're going to plan and reach adults ages 18 to 34. If you care about reaching certain Google-specific audiences, you'll have the option to layer that at a later point in time. Then, you select the dates for your forecast. In this case, you'll see that the forecast dates are in the future. This will correspond to the YouTube forecasting component of your plan, but will also correspond to the duration with which we are incorporating historical TV measurement. You can see that the plan has a duration of 7 days. I will share how that gets incorporated a little bit later. One important note is that in a handful of countries like Vietnam, we only have ability to use durations like 7 or 28 days of TV reach data in our campaigns. With that done, let's select TV campaign information. You'll see two options, a sample campaign or a specific campaign. Let's try a specific campaign. A specific campaign allows you to select individual TV campaigns from the last 1.5 years worth of historical data. I'm going to show you a Google Inc. campaign, and you can see the dates the TV campaign ran. I mentioned earlier about a 7 or 28 day duration. You'll notice that we've taken a subset of the total campaign, and that's because we're taking a portion of the TV campaign data that has a matching duration to the TV plus YouTube forecast that you want to create. Once you select the TV campaign, you'll be able to change the period that you can use to either 7 or 28 days of the TV campaign period. This will give you an option whether you want to plan your campaign on a weekly or monthly basis. Once you've selected the specific TV campaign, we will give you the campaign size, the rate card cost as provided to us by a third-party provider. You will have the opportunity to input a discount on the rate card that is appropriate for your particular agency, advertiser, or client. You can adjust the actual cost to better reflect the TV price closer to what was actually paid. Now, let's try planning for 28 days and using a sample campaign. A sample campaign is actually recreated from campaign data collected over the course of the last 1.5 years in the country or region that you selected. This matches the campaign size on a cost or TRP basis, similar prices on a CPM or cost per demographic TRP basis. In this example, we are going to find similar campaigns from the last 1.5 years that match 1,000 TRPs at roughly $800 cost per target rating point. At this point, simply select some of the specifics associated with your YouTube campaign and you're almost done. You can input what creative length you have available. In this case, let's say we have 6-second and 15-second creatives. That is going to give us a recommendation of skippable in-stream and bumper ads. These are ad formats matching the length of your creative that will give you the best ability to maximize reach and awareness of your TV and YouTube campaign. We are at the final step. Simply click View Forecast. What is happening now is that we are creating your forecast in the way that was mentioned before. We're taking historical TV data and using the conditional independence model to deduplicate it with YouTube forecasting data to give you a likely expected future forecast for a campaign containing both TV and YouTube. You'll see that some of the settings that you chose, like location, dates, and demographic, are available above. Here you can see that we've created a plan that contains both TV and YouTube. For more information on how to set up your forecast, see the link in the description below the video.